I've come out here on days when it's so windy and not nice like this, and had lots and lots of manatees. I had a group of six ladies last year who were going home to Virginia. 100 birds are on these islands. You don't see green, you see white, brown, slate gray, black. They look like bird Christmas trees. All the babies flying away. All the babies.
This would be better to come on this trip.
They use these islands at night, folks, as a place to roost, to sleep. It's a safe place. It's out in the middle of water. If they were to sleep on the trees that are way off ahead of you, from the distance to the right and to the left, those are attached to Sanibel Island. Guess what's there? Chest, you would see it's white on the chest. Yes, that's an osprey.
That might not be what we see.
Yeah, and see the eyes, the color under the eyes too. The bill isn't nearly as long or as curved and large.
Now their nest, did they build their nest high up like an
eagle? Osprey always build their nests so they have 360 vision all the way around. Because the mother never leaves. that long, slender bill that it has, it's using that to catch fish that get too close to it. In the water, and on the trees below, right above the water, are all your cormorants. So you can see there's like a pecking order up there, where the bigger birds are on top, the brown pelicans, and the cormorants are down towards the bottom. Younger birds on the bottom because you can see the lighter colored chest. Now they're dropping into the water. It's becoming a little frightened as we go by. 100 pounds of grass every day for a manatee. That's a lot of grass. I'm going to tuck it over here to the side and see up close what these mangroves look like, and maybe in here we'll have some calmer water and we might have a few of those critters popping up for us. So let's look over here. But as we're going through, guys, do take a look at the amazing root structure of these red mangrove trees. And I think if you look closely at the roots, you'll understand where the name red comes from. They have that reddish coloration, don't they? All those little roots digging down into the water, into the mud, they're only going into about a foot of mud beneath maybe a foot and a half to 2 feet of water. Those are called prop roots, like your fingers propping the trees up out of the water. If you look closely at the ends where the trees are closer to the water, you'll see roots dropping down from the branches. Those are called drop roots. So it's those drop roots and prop roots which actually secure these red mangrove trees to the surface beneath the water. It's shallow here.
Now it's still going down.
Well, you can see how they can hide if you're a fish inside all those little openings. It's a perfect place.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.